Oh, looks like we're live. Speedy Gonzales style. That's good. Sweet. Hopefully we stay live. Last couple of times it was breaks right at the beginning of the live stream. So that's good. Yeah, looks like it's good. So this is the fourth live stream we're doing today. We're calling it a day of math. Sort of multiple sessions, open discussion. And we did basically mainly math on the first session, which was 9 a.m. this morning. And on the second session, we did half of math, and then we started talking about comics books. And in the last session, we mainly talked about comic books, and we did one math question. And we talked a little bit about education and whatnot. So we're going to continue it. This is our last 1 hour session. Whatchamacallit? We'll see what comes up. If anybody has math questions, for sure, let's talk about mathematics. We got the sun going through us, it's sort of through the skylight. On the last session, the sun was shining directly on me. It was bright. Hopefully that wasn't annoying for people. It was okay with me. It got me nice and hot, good temperature. And right now we got the sun over here. So on this camera, oh, it's not bad. A few minutes ago, it was actually right on top of here, so we couldn't even see the writing. So we can actually do a little bit of mathematics if any questions come up. It'll give a little bit of time for people to stroll in if they're into being here. If they want to do a little bit of mathematics, we'll see. Or talk about something else. And what we did in the last couple of streams anyway, basically the last one full on and the one previous half of it, I started going through some of the comics that I've been reading, more recent stuff, my basically reading pile or reader copies, I guess, right? And we've gone through a bunch and we have this much to go through. Hello, Weasley. Hi again, Chicho, he says. Hello to you too. Welcome back to our last live stream of the day, right? And we will definitely be doing more math streams, but they're going to be more the version that, and if you're on YouTube, you're going to be watching this, and if you've been following what I've been loading up on Twitter and YouTube and stuff, between the first and second stream, I loaded up the how to take notes video that we did, the behind the scenes, where we did a live stream of me doing a recording of one of the ASMR math videos. So we're going to do more of that type of content over the summer, but I don't think we'll do too many more open math discussions since the school year is out. Unless people requested, we'll do open math discussion and talk about stuff. And we're basically doing this for today because it's exam season. So I thought if anybody had any math questions, anything that they're cramming for or need answers for, if I could help you out, I will definitely try my best to help you out. And that's a couple of the questions that have come up today in the previous streams. We did one inequality question, this one here. The person had just written the test and they wanted to find out if they did it correctly or not. And they made a mistake by flipping the inequality sign. You only flip it if you multiply or divide by a negative number. So let me erase this here just in case math questions come up. If they don't, we're gonna go through more comic books. I've already shown you about a stack double the size of this that I've gone through since showing you guys what I've been reading in a previous video that we put out, right? So we cleared that off. And I put my glasses back on. It's weird weather here. It was darker earlier today and then now it's like bright, so the eyes are like googly. They're adjusting to like sun hitting them and whatnot. It's springtime, summertime. So again, if anybody's coming on, if you have any math questions, we'll do. Otherwise, let me show you the other books I've been reading. And this is my reader copy stuff. So sort of a pile of books, which is probably around this high right now of books like this, reader copies that I have around, just in case if anybody wants to, anybody comes to the place, to the house, and they want to read comic books, instead of giving them stuff in bags and boards, because some people are, they get a little anxious of reading comics like this, and it's, if they're not used to comic books, I really don't want to hand them an expensive comic book, which they're afraid to read, right? And they might damage and affect the value of the book and bring down the grade. So I keep stacks like this, just for people to read and for myself. Sometimes I go through years later. Some of the stuff, the stack that I showed you was comics that I had reader copies stuck in boxes. And sometimes I just randomly pick a box and go through it to see what's in there. And I pulled out some of these things and I make things tighter because things get squished. So I try to fit as, not as much as I can, but enough so the comics aren't being squished too much. But sometimes there's more room because you really don't want comics and boxes to be leaning either, right? So I check the boxes to make sure things aren't leaning on each other, everything's sort of upright. So if there's room, I put in some comic books, right? And I pull out any reader copies that I might have read like years ago. Okay, so let me show you some more of these books that we've read or I've read. I mentioned this, and then we cut it short because a math question came up. But one of the comic book publishing companies that I've been following is Aftershock Comics, and I try to sample as much as I can from Aftershock. And I picked up Baby Teeth when it first came out, but my comic shop, I didn't read it. The first couple of issues I picked up, two or three issues I picked up, and my comic book store where I have my pull list, they do put out sort of back stock of stuff that they have for a dollar. And all everything that you see here is either from Free Comic Book Day or stuff that I pulled out of my boxes. Well, these ones aren't anything I pulled out of my boxes, but sometimes there's stuff that I pulled out of my boxes, reader copies, or stuff that I bought for a dollar Canadian, right? So these are like 70, I guess, Canadian exchange rate to US dollars right now is 77, 78 cents. So I picked these up for $1 Canadian or 70, 80 cents US, right? And this was a good read. Okay, I was pleasantly surprised. I picked it up, I had it on my pull list, and I read it. I didn't read it. I flipped through it, and it didn't grasp me just flipping through it. I had a lot of books on my thing, so I bought this the $1 just to read because the other one's bagged and boarded in the boxes now. And I was very pleasantly surprised. And I was, I want to give you a spoiler, but I won't. But the story is basically about a girl who's pregnant, is about to give birth, and it's just basically that story. The artwork's okay. It's not, it's not mind-boggling, okay? But it goes with the story, and it was a good story. And I'm gonna keep it in mind. And if I get the opportunity, if I can get the trade at a good price, or if I see an auction on eBay where I can pick these up on the cheap, as you know, if I find a buyer that's selling their collection, usually preferably individual collectors, I try to, if I have money saved up, I try to grab as much as I can from them, right? The last time I did this for one seller, just a private collector who was selling off his collection, we ended up buying 1,000 comic books for like, dollar Canadian, a pop, bagged and boarded, all of them basically in near mint condition, right? Most of them like 80% unread, if not more, right? So that was a great haul. So I'm gonna keep this in mind. If I can find Baby Teeth, a set of it where it has the later issues, I'll definitely pick it up. And this is written by Donnie Cates, and the artwork is by Gary Brown. Okay, fun read, fun read. This is True Believers Marvel reprint of Wolverine number one, the continuing series that came out, right? And this was fun to read. It was good to read. I read the first, I don't know how many Wolverines I've read from this series, but I've read a fair bit of it. Okay, and it was good rereading this, and I forgot how not exaggerated this was. It was more about just the storytelling, and it wasn't all just fight scenes. So there was a lot of good comics that came out in the 1980s and 1990s as well. There were phenomenal comic books that came out in the 1990s. I know comic books get a bad rep, but they were fantastic. They were an amazing period back then, 1980s and 1990s. And this is the cover of Wolverine number one. Okay. So True Believer stuff, I am picking up, and a lot of the other reprint sale $1 books that they're putting out. Okay. This one is, I was pleasantly surprised. DC Comics putting out Nation number zero. And how can you turn this down? 25-cent comic, right? An introduction to sort of, I guess this is the Justice League stuff. I read this thing and sort of a new direction that DC Comics is going with. So it was basically the intro to the new Justice League with Justice League Blue, Red, or whatever it is. Hello, Sage 4. Hello again to you as well. Welcome back to another stream. I went full on into just straight up going into the comics, gave a little intro, and I'm showing you the comic books I'm reading, right? And this was good for 25 cents. Seriously, you can't go wrong. Like 25 cents, it's like free, right? So picked it up, read it, nice. I'm not picking up the Justice League stuff. I'm full up on my superhero reads with Valiance, and I'm picking up Amazing Spider-Man and Batman and stuff, right? Just taking it up to the wedding issue with Batman number 50, I believe. And Amazing Spider-Man, I was picking up all the Red Goblin and pre-Red Goblin stuff. And I still haven't read them. I flipped through them. I've read pages, but I haven't read the whole thing yet. And I think I'll wait up until they put out a compilation or read the whole thing in one shot. I do have the issues out, the singles, so I might just read the singles. Okay. And some of those things, the prices have gone up on them, right? They've kicked up in price. Another book that I read, and I'm reading a lot of independents, Image, Valiant, Black Mask, and IDW, picking up IDW as well, right? So I read Giant Killer number zero, and it wasn't bad. It's Bart Sears, okay, written writing and art by Bart Sears. That's the first part of the story. Okay, this is number zero, so a sort of compilation, just three different stories. The second story was written by Ron Mars, and the third story again is written by Bart Sears. And the artwork, I like Bart Sears. Bart Sears used to do some phenomenal artwork. I like his work in the 90s more than the artwork more recently. The stuff I think was more intricate, especially some stuff he did for Valiant. He did XO number 14 and XO number 15 back in the 90s for Valiant. Was it XO? Yeah, I believe it was XO. And they were fantastic. And this was, it wasn't bad. It's more mythology, supernatural, fantasy related. Right. Nice artwork. It's world building right now going on. And, if I get the opportunity, I might continue this read. I'm not 100% sure, but it's not really on my reading list. Okay. Another book from IDW. Okay. It's more sci-fi related. It's Transformers, basically. But First Strike. Okay, G.I. Joe stuff. And again, my comic book store had this for a dollar. I picked it up. I read it. It wasn't bad. It's very G-rated. If you don't include all the violence, there's a fair bit of violence here, right? It was okay. But I'm not really reading any G.I. Joe comics or Transformer comics. I've heard some of the newer Transformer comics are pretty good, but I haven't got the opportunity to read them yet. So if you like Transformers, G.I. Joe, it wasn't a bad read. The story was told well, it flowed nicely, and there wasn't anything where I was like, you know, what's going on? I don't know this part of it or that part of it. It was a fun read. It was a good read. Okay. This book, Infinity War, Marvel True Believers reprint of Infinity War, and Infinity War basically came out in the 90s after the Infinity Gauntlet. So Infinity Gauntlet with Thanos was 6 issues, right? And it crossed over into some other titles as well. It really spun off from Reed 345. Yo, how you doing? So Infinity Gauntlet, the storyline basically started off with Silver Surfer. I showed you one of the ones I read, basically was Thanos coming back and Silver Surfer from, I believe that Silver Surfer series that started in the 1980s, late 1980s. But Thanos, I believe, made his comeback in Silver Surfer 34. And let's kind of find it. Let's check it out. Let's check it out. Oh, here we go. This one. So I believe Thanos made his return in Silver Surfer. I believe this is number 34. Is it number 34? Yeah, this is number 34. It might be. I believe this is the first one, and the Infinity Gauntlet made his first appearance in Thanos 44, I believe. Something like that, anyway. But I was following the stuff when it was first coming out to a certain degree. I had to go back and buy some of the previous issues because of Infinity Gauntlet. I really liked the Infinity Gauntlet mini that came out in the 90s. It was fantastic with the crossovers and Silver Surfer 50 that kicked in to Infinity Gauntlet. And before that, I think Thanos Quest 1 and 2. Thanos Quest number 1 and 2, brilliant. Okay, fantastic reads. Okay. And once all the Infinity Gauntlet stuff was over with all the crossovers, basically it kicked into Infinity War. Okay. And I picked up the first couple of issues back in the 90s when this first came out, but I didn't really follow it. I wasn't really into it. I was. Marvel did what Marvel does. It just. Yeah, just overwhelmed you with stuff, right? So I got sort of burnt out. Hello, Wilson, how are you doing? Welcome to a stream. Good to see you all. Welcome, welcome. This is the fourth stream that we're doing today, right? So I picked this one up, okay, Infinity War. It was sort of and Wilson, by the way, it's supposed to be an open mouth discussion. If again, if anybody's popping up, there's a few more people coming in. Hello, Index. Hello, Wilson. So many people. So if anybody's coming in, if you have math questions, let me know. We'll deal with math as well. But as long as we're not talking about mathematics, we're going through my comic book reads, what I've been reading, sort of as reader copies. Okay. And we got about four more. I got about four more to show you guys. And then we'll talk about whatever you guys want. If it's mathematics, mathematics. If not, we'll talk about something else. But I ended up reading this one. I don't think I read it in the 1990s. I can't remember reading it because it doesn't ring a bell. I did pick up the first two couple issues, maybe just the first issue. I know I've seen it in my collection. So I ended up reading this. Who was the artist? What, I don't know if, I don't think it was Starlin doing it. Was it Starlin? Who was this? Doesn't even say. Let's check it out. Let's check it out. Yeah, it is Jim Starlin and Ron Lim. So, you know, I'm not sure why I didn't read it. I was just overwhelmed by it, right? Swank, thank you for the Twitch Prime sub, brother. Great to have you here. Okay, so I'm not sure why I didn't pick it up because I love Ron Lim's artwork. Okay, oops, Ron Lim's artwork and Jim Starlin's writing, phenomenal. And Jim Starlin and Ron Lim, if I'm not mistaken, also did Thanos Quest, and that was fantastic. Deadpool Greater, than every other Marvel character. Nice. Marvel characters, I like Deadpool. I love Deadpool. Deadpool's fantastic, right? As if you see my comic book collection, the first one that I showed you guys, or I was showing you my comic book collection, I have like three, four, five copies of New Mutants number 98, right? And I have some of the early Deadpool. I love Deadpool, right? But as far as loving really a character that I sort of cherish from the Marvel Universe, I love Thanos. That's one reason I loved Thanos Quest and Infinity Gauntlet and went back and bought all the Thanos appearances and Silver Surfer. And at the time, there weren't too many people buying that stuff. I was picking that stuff up. That's super cheap, right? Like a dollar or $1.25, like cover price, if not less, right? But one character that I love from the Marvel Universe is Carnage. Okay, because Carnage to me is Marvel's answer to the Joker. He's just, as the saying goes, Joker likes to see the world burn. Carnage likes to see the world burn for no reason. Okay. Glad I finally caught a stream. You got me interested into comics. Currently reading everything Valiant because of you. Also, I hope you're enjoying it, man. I hope you're enjoying it. They're putting out, I'm way behind on my Valiants. I'm reading what I can. I showed the in the last stream I had someone asked if they could have what was some kind of story where it's first person story being told, and I showed the Divinity hardcover that I have, the Omnibus, which includes Divinity 1, 2, 3, and Divinity number 0. What a fantastic read that was. So I'm reading a lot of the Valiants, or trying to read as much Valiants as possible, but I'm way behind. I'm hoping to catch up in the summer. Not many comic book stores near me here in the UK, but I'm looking forward to buying some online. Yeah, for me, if you're looking to buy back issues, just because they're so expensive, the budget, comic book budget only goes so far. As you know, I try to buy lots on eBay if I can get them on the cheap. I thought Carnage was Venom all these years. Don't ask why. Well, it's Venom's kid, right? It's Venom's offspring. Same here, up in the north, Norway. Oh wow, Norway, cool. So, from what I understand, from the sounds of it, in Europe there aren't too many specific comic shops, so you guys have a hard time getting your hands on US and Canadian comic books coming out, right? So basically, you have to buy them all online and you have to pay for all the shipping, if I'm not mistaken. So that must end up costing a fair bit. EXO and Ninjak are my favorites so far. Love that. Visgoth War, yes, same here. EXO is fantastic. He's so raw, right? My library gives me a free comic book pass subscription so I can get caught up. Oh, sweet, sweet. Canada for the win. There are some of the big cities, but in my Worcestershire, so Worcestershire. So not many comic shops. Wow. Okay. Yeah, and the shipping is too damn high. Yeah, same in Canada. The shipping here is insane, right? So I try to buy from Canadian sellers if I can. Closer by the better. If I can find people in Vancouver or Victoria that I can go pick up the comics, even better, right? And that way I don't get nailed at the border with duties and stuff as well. For sure. As far as Valiant goes, just recently there is a pic of Vin Diesel as Bloodshot, and I hope you know, Swank, the as far as the Valiant movies goes, they signed Vin Diesel to be Bloodshot in the Bloodshot movie, the first Valiant movie that's going to come out. And there's a pic of Bloodshot, some artist did Vin Diesel and Bloodshot outfit showing, and that just came online. It came online a couple of days ago, but they took it down, and it's available now again, and it looks fantastic. If I have my fingers crossed, they'll be able to do a good job on that. Okay, heading out. Hockey playoffs. Wow. I know it's not your thing, Chicho, but for most Canadians, we need it. Yeah, I know for sure. Canada and hockey are huge, huge. If you're actually not into hockey, and you get into a discussion with Canadians, and they find out you're not really into hockey or professional sport, they sort of question if you're a true Canadian or not. So I've been in discussions like that before. One time I almost got into a scuffle with people because I wasn't watching hockey, and it was like weird. I couldn't figure it out. There was alcohol involved, obviously. There was hockey playoffs and stuff going on. I hope you enjoy the playoffs, brother. Index. I used to be into professional sports. I used to watch a lot, but I don't anymore. That's super cool. I just got introduced into him through Armor Hunters. Yeah, Armor Hunters. What a great series that was. Fantastic. That was one of the best crossovers I've ever read. Armor Hunters was so good, and it gave you such an amazing appreciation for Exo Armor and and everyone involved in that, right? With Eric out. I pronounce it Eric. Some people pronounce it differently. With Eric, and what a fantastic series that was. It was an 18 issue series that crossed over into some of the other titles, right? Highly recommend if you want an event to read, Valiant's Armor Hunters. The stereotype is strong in this one. The stereotype. I'm assuming you're talking about sports or what do you call it, the hockey stuff. I am not into hockey, and it is a mess whenever I tell someone that. Yeah, seriously, it's for some reason it turns out being fighting words with some people. Thanks for the stream. My pleasure, Index. Thank you for coming here, brother. Thank you for being here. Thank you for questions and interaction. It's a lot of fun. Oof. Young blood. Hey, is that Rob Layfield's young blood? I'm assuming so. I'm assuming so. So as far as Infinity War goes, it was a good read. I liked it. I liked the art. I liked the way the story unfolded. And since I haven't read this whole thing, I might pick it up at some point and read it. Okay. So Jim Starlin, fantastic, really. From the 1980s and 1990s, and Ron Lim, together they did an amazing job. They did an amazing job. Another comic I picked up, I picked up the first few issues. It was on my pull list, okay, and I didn't get a chance to read it, and I dropped it. And then again, my comic book store had it for $1, and I picked it up. And this reads Swank's comment, and this is regarding, it's got to be regarding Armor Hunters. Even the villains were dynamic. I just saw that pic of Vin Diesel as Bloodshot. Looks great. Hopefully the movie goes well so we can get more Valiant on film. Yeah, same here. Me, you, and every Valiant fan has their fingers crossed that they do a good job. And you know what? I got a core feeling that they're gonna do a good job, because what they did, the basically the online Ninjak versus the Valiant universe, the short videos that were supposed to come out a few months ago, they prevented that from coming off. From this is rumors that I read, some stuff that I read. So the studio, the people that bought on Valiant, right? They, what's a Valiant? Valiant is independent comic book publishing company. It's another comic book publishing company that has a contained universe. It's the only other comic book publishing company that their whole line is contained one universe, just like Marvel or DC, right? All the other independent publishers, all their titles are not interconnected. Valiant Comics, all their titles are interconnected. So just picture Marvel or DC, but with different types of heroes, different types of characters. And in general, basically 99% of the books that Valiant puts out, they're more mature readers, okay? And they're Marvel and DC, I don't want to trash them because they do put out some good books, right? But in general, there's a lot of censorship going on Marvel or DC, and they're geared towards more a preteen or a teen audience. Valiant comic books are a little bit more mature, as in broad strokes across the universe, right? So they're more in depth and they're deeper characters, and the what goes on with them is very interconnected and they're tight. The stories that they're telling in the Valiant universe is very tight. There's very little discrepancy or things that go haywire from one writer to another writer, from one series to another series. So it's a beautiful universe to read. Okay. As far as the just the Armor Hunters, going back to the Armor Hunters story, the crossover that Valiant did, it ran for 18 issues, right? One of the most beautiful thing, I might be giving a little bit of spoiler, but it's not too much. There's a lot going on in that crossover. But what you end up realizing with Armor Hunters is that the people, the story is basically these people are trying to hunt down the Exo Man of War armor and they're trying to destroy it. And there's a reason for it. And they give the reason for it. And all of a sudden, you initially you think these people are the villains, but you realize that they have a very good reason for what it is that they're doing. Okay. And there, when I was reading this, there was a core sort of conflict within me. You know that they're not gonna destroy the Exo Man of War armor. In large part, you know that, or they might be an offspring. You know it's not going to disappear from the universe, but you realize that the Exo armor is not what you thought it was, and all of a sudden you realize there are no heroes and villains in this story being told. In this, what do they call it? Space opera to a certain degree, taking place on Earth, being told there are just characters doing what they need to do. Right, what their core beliefs are, and you want them all to fail, you want them all to succeed. It's beautiful. It's not bipolar. It's more mature. It's more intricate. So that's what Valiant comic books are like to me, and to many other people that I've read. So a lot of people that from Valiant people, if you ask them, you know, who do you prefer, Marvel or DC? Our reply is Valiant. I don't prefer Marvel or DC. Valiant all the way, and I read certain comics from Marvel and DC. I read less comics from Marvel and DC than I do from Aftershock or Dark Horse or Image, right? So those are my top reads right now. Okay. What's a Valiant? You said that's what a Valiant is. Just look up Valiant comics. I think I might need to check out Valiant Comics books now. For sure, try them out. They have a whole bunch of different stuff. There are some misses in their line of books as well, but the ratio is like it's not Marvel or DC. Marvel or DC, to me, you know, 20% of Marvel or DC books are good. 80% I don't need to look at, right? Maybe 5% of Marvel or DC books, I would say they were fantastic. DC did a great job with Rebirth, by the way. Rebirth, their percentage of really good books kicked up a lot, right? But in terms of Valiant percentage-wise, 80 plus percent of their books are phenomenal reads. And that's a huge, huge ratio, right? So if you do pick up Valiant comics and you have a miss, you don't like it, try something else, okay? And if you're not finding anything after two tries, send me a message, tell me what you like, and I'll give you some recommendations, some stuff that blew me away. Okay? Thank you for the stream, Chicho. I got to go to bed waking up at 6 hours. Oh, wow. I hope you have a good sleep, brother. My pleasure. My pleasure. Thank you for being here, Weasley. Swank, do you like Shadow? I love Shadow Man. I love Shadow Man. I am a few issues in. And I'm not sold right away like I was for Exo and Eternal Warrior. Eternal Warrior, Wrath of the Eternal Warrior, Book of Death, kicking in to Wrath of the Eternal Warrior, phenomenal. And by the way, Sage 4, if you want to have a good read, something I can recommend for Valiant Comics, there's a 4-issue Book of Death miniseries that came out, and there's a 4-issue complimentary thing that came out, which was called Legends of the Geomancer. Valiant, it made it exclusive. They're not going to reprint it. So I did the 4 readings of those comics on my channel, Legends of the Geomancer. But you don't need to read those ones. Well, it's important to read those ones, right? So Wrath of the Eternal Warrior, you should read Book of Death 1 to 4. If you were looking for recommendation for Valiant Comics, read Book of Death number 1 to 4. Read Legends of the Geomancer number 1 to 4, or you can find them online from sites, pirated sites. That's one of the reasons I got banned from the Reddit comic book forum, because I posted a link to those reads and then I got unbanned again, right? And then after reading those 8 issues, go into Wrath of the Eternal Warrior. And remember, this is not the Eternal Warrior, but Wrath of the Eternal Warrior. And it's a how many issues? 12 issues? Swank, if you can correct me on this. I don't know if it was 8 issues or 12 issues or 10 issues. I think it was 12 issues. Fantastic reads. Okay. As far as Shadow Man is concerned, with the relaunch of Valiant since 2012, what they've put out is not bad. There's a couple of issues that I read which were phenomenal. Okay. And the issues were, I'm going to come right back. Okay. Let me go grab the trade paperback. I have the singles as well, but let me grab the trade paperback so I direct you to the right ones. Okay. I'll be back in 30 seconds. Hi again. May I ask a math question? 100%. Ask away. As soon as I talk about Shadow Man, I will definitely answer your math question if I can. Okay. So these are three of the trades. Which numbers are these? This is volume 2, volume 3, volume. I think it's in volume 3. Let me see which ones. Yeah, this is it. Just regarding Shadow Man, so Youngblood, for sure, ask away your math question. And as soon as I finish this, I'll read your question and we'll do a little bit of mathematics. So, as far as Shadow Man is concerned, I got sold on Shadow Man from the 1990s. Shadow Man, the early issues of Shadow Man from the 1990s, fantastic. There was very few things, few comic books out there during that period that were like Shadow Man. He didn't have amazing superpowers or anything like this. He was basically, I prefer basically solo books, except for I've read a lot of X-Men. I love X-Men, and I've read a lot of Harbinger stuff, and I love the Harbinger stuff, right? And I do like Excalibur. I do like some team books, but I prefer solo books, solo characters. And Shadow Man, the early 1990s stuff, issue 1 to, I can't remember where, like 15 or something, I read. They were fantastic. The first few issues before and kicking into Unity, Shadow Man really stood out. And that's where I fell in love with Shadow Man and realized the potential of Shadow Man. But if you want to read fantastic Shadow Man stories, read Shadow Man. Let me make sure I got the right ones. Yeah, these ones. So good. Okay. This is Shadow Man number 0. Okay. Hopefully it's these ones. Shadow Man number 0. And it basically, are you for sure? I love the Spawn animation from the 90s, and I read some of the early Spawn. But I haven't been following up on Spawn. And this story line, there's basically 2 issues which really stood out, and they're basically about a Master Dark's children. And as far as evil villains is concerned, in all of comic books, Master Dark, to me, is Master Dark, Harada, Thanos, and Darkseid are three, four of the best villains in comic book history. Okay? And Master Dark, Harada is amazing, right? And Master Dark, again, this character right here is fantastic. And I believe it's Shadow Man number 0. And it might be Shadow Man number 10 that tell the story of Master Dark's children. So if you want to know, yeah, here's the back cover for this. Check that out. Shadow Man number 0 and Shadow Man number 10. Read these two issues, they're standalones. Okay. Actually, read number 1 and then read number 10. And that should sell you on the Shadow Man universe of how amazing it is and how brilliant the stories could be. And the artwork's really beautiful for it, and the stories are deep. Okay. Really. So it's hit and miss with Shadow Man because I don't think that's the one character in the Valiant universe. I don't think they've done it justice yet. Okay. Thanks for the recommendations. I will make sure to check these out. Awesome. I hope you enjoy. I hope you enjoy. Okay. By the way, Youngblood, if you have a math question, let us know. I'll answer it as soon as you post it. Okay. And we've got about 20 minutes left in the stream, so hopefully you can get the question out within that 20 minutes. If you get it out on the last minute of the stream, we'll stay on and continue to, you know, try to do the question. Okay. As far as the last four comic books in my reading comics pile goes, okay, Grass Kings from Boom Studios, right? It was a good read. It's not superhero, it's just talking about you know what? I just read this one issue. I picked up the first three, I believe, but I haven't read the other two. But the artwork is very unique. Okay, it's pretty. Okay. It's all I think it's oil paint, or sorry, watercolor. I think it's watercolor, so it's beautiful. And watercolor has a certain feel to it. I know Jeff Lemire, I think, has done a fair bit of watercolor. And this is who are the creators for this? Oh yeah, the writer for this is Matt Kinnett, and illustrations by Tyler Jerkins. Okay, so it's just basically a story about a community. This first issue, and it was very well done. And I will definitely keep my eye out for this if I see an auction on eBay that has a few of these, few of the shoes in a row. I will definitely pick it up. Okay. Another comic that I read recently. Okay, I will give it another try. I just read the Eternal Warrior arc and loved it. Awesome. Good stuff. Yeah, Shadow Man number 0 and number 10. Read those two issues. Unfortunately, right after number 10 is number 11, I believe, and it wasn't very good. I didn't, you know, Dr. Mirage comes into play, I believe, in number 11. Yeah, it was sort of like a Halloween special. Is it Dr. Mirage? Yeah, Dr. Mirage comes into play, and you know, don't read number 11. You can if you want. It wasn't a bad read. It'd be an average or above par Marvel or DC book, but for Valiant, it was a miss. Okay, and number 12, I don't remember what number 12 was, but Shadow Man number 0, Shadow Man number 10. Stop there and then maybe dabble in some other stuff. Okay, another thing that I just recently read again is Infinite Gauntlet number 1. I picked up the $1 True Believers copy, and I hadn't read this for a long time. I read these when they first came out, like I said, and it was fun reading it. I like this book, is fantastic. What a great series. And again, it's Jim Starlin, right? And pencils with this was George Perez. So I guess Ron Lim did Thanos Quest 1 and 2, and George Perez did the pencils for Infinity Gauntlet, right? Thanos right? That's when he's got the full gauntlet, where, you know, I'm gonna give away spoilers, but he snaps his fingers, right? And Mephisto goes, "I can't believe he did it." Okay. Something else that I read recently, where I picked it up again, was a dollar True Believers. Okay, Jonathan Hickman, Jerome Opena, Infinicity Incoming. Okay, just read this. It doesn't stand out. It really didn't do anything for me. Have to flip through it just to remind myself what it was about. Yeah, it just didn't do it for me. I'm sorry, Hickman. Right. And I'm sorry, Marvel. Sorry, Captain America and Thor and Wolverine and Hulk and stuff, but it's just too many holes, too many discrepancies, too much stuff that I dialogue that I don't understand, because you have to have read all the different variations of all the different universes and reboots and stuff. It's just a mess as far as I was concerned. Okay. So it really didn't do too much for me. It didn't intrigue me to pick up anything. Okay. And I'll share with you something else that I'm picking up. And this is from Devil's Due First Comics. Okay. They're or First Comics, right? And they're one of the more adult oriented independent publishers. They're not for everyone. I don't read too much stuff from them. Okay. And this became part of my, it's for mature readers, this one. I wasn't really going to share this, but might as well do, right? It's called Malefic. Okay. It's more along the lines, it's mature readers for sure. This is not for kids. Do not read this if, and do not buy this for kids. Okay. It's more along the lines of Faust. If you remember the 19, I think Faust came out in the 1980s. It's over the top. It's black and white. There's gore. There's, let me find a page where it doesn't have things that are like just too much, just to give you a feel for the artwork. There's demons and demonic possessions and like trying to find a page that is made. You know, here's a page. Like, this is the style of artwork, okay? Black and white, and it's for mature readers, okay? And I'm picking this up because I love supporting independent comic book publishers, and it's different, it's unique, it stands out, okay? And it's 6 issues deep, and at the back of this, they say Malefic number 7 is going to be out in March, January, February. I guess that's 2019, so they've taken a huge break, right? So I guess what they're doing is they're doing 6-issue runs, doing the stuff, and then soliciting with Diamond. And I believe there's going to be like a compilation of this, like a trade paperback put out, you know, putting all 6 issues together, right? So if you're okay with, if you know what I'm talking about when it comes to Faust comic book, this is along those lines, and it has to do with supernatural, and there's gore, there's nudity, there's sex, Mature readers. Okay. Warning given. And that's about it. That's what I've been reading for the last. This is what I picked up for just the reader copies, by the way. I've read other stuff as well, trade paperbacks and other single issues that I've been picking up from my pull list. But these are some of the randoms I've picked up on the cheap, and then my reader copies or floaters just hanging around if someone wants to read a certain type of book. And then what I try to do with this reader copies that I have in the stacks, like this high now, is have a sampling of different types of comic books, right? So if someone comes to the house and says, "Hey, do you have any comic books I can read?" And first thing I'll ask them is, "What type of comic book do you want to read?" And then I'll go through the stack and drop them a few and say, "Try some of these, see what you think." And I don't mind lending these ones out for people to take home to read and then they bring back. The only I don't lend out any of the bags and boards, my comic collection, to anyone. Okay. Reader copies, I do lend out, but I expect them back before they can get anything else. Okay, the only other comic books I've lent out to people to read, and they were family, was Savage sort of Conan connection collection that I inherited from a friend of mine, which we did a video for where we showed all the covers and read the Comic Code Authority, what their criteria was, and Savage sort of Conan could bypass the Comic Code Authority because it was a magazine, right? So they didn't have to abide by it. And I actually contacted my friend, and since putting out that video, and I mentioned to him that, "Hey, I have all the stuff you left for me to take care of, and I bagged and boarded all of them, and I put them in a ma in a magazine bag, and I packaged it all up, and I knew where he was. He was in Malaysia, right? So I said, "Hey, I have these comic books." He left them for me in 92, 90, 93, possibly 1993. So I've had him with me for about 25 years. And I said, "Hey," and he has kids, and I said, "Hey, I have this stuff. They're all bagged and boarded, packed in a box. I can send them to you. Let me know where to send them." And he goes, "Hold off, hold off. Don't send them to me because there's major censorship in Malaysia or Indonesia. I always mix them up. Malaysia or Indonesia. I think it's Indonesia. Indonesia. Malaysia. Malaysia. The one that's Muslim, majority Muslim. The huge censorship." And he said, "Don't send them to me because he'll get nailed and they'll get stopped at the border and he won't get them anyway and he'll be put on the radar, right? So I have them. They're gonna stay with me indefinitely." Okay, and that's about it. That's what I've been reading. So this stream ended up just being a comic book stream, unless Youngblood's gonna come and ask us a math question. So Youngblood, ask a math question. Let's finish this off with a little bit of mathematics if you have it. This is the Sage Forest, like laughing about I think male thing. If Youngblood's not gonna come back with a math question, we can. For the rest of the stream, for like 10 minutes or so, we can talk about anything else you guys want to talk about. Maybe politics, economics, more comic books, right? And thank you for everyone for being here, by the way, for this day of streams that we did. It was fun doing it. I actually love doing this, just putting a whole day aside and doing a stream every hour, right? Boom, boom, boom. Next time, I think I'll just make independent event pages for each hour that we're doing a stream for. That way, you know, the word, the I guess the automatic notice goes out to people that they know that there's going to be a stream instead of saying that we're going to do, you know, the different times in the description of the event for Twitch. So we'll make separate event pages for each stream that we're going to do. Okay. And for those of you who are checking on YouTube, between the first and second stream, I uploaded the video that we did where I showed you guys my notes. Beside Valiant, what other publishers should I look into? Image Comics, 100%. Image Comics is fantastic. Aftershock is putting out some good books. Okay. Black Mask is doing a good job. Okay, a Dark Horse is doing a fantastic job. Oh, I'm missing some. They're not. There's a couple other ones that I'm picking up. At Atlantic, not Atlantic. Oh, I can't remember the other ones. There's one comic book publisher that's publishing books, and they're pricing all their comics at $1.50. Okay, and I've skimmed through some of them. I haven't read any of them. I skimmed through some of them, and from what I understand, they're good comic books. So if you're on a budget, there's a comic book publisher, and I don't have it here right now. And all the books are $1.50. They're one third the price of, or one quarter of the price of all the other comic book publishers, especially Marvel and DC, Marvel especially, right? So it's worth picking them up as well. They're on my pull list, and I'm picking up everything that they're putting out. So there's a lot of independents which are putting out some really good books. Really good books. Valiant, Image, Aftershock, Dark Horse. IDW is putting out some good stuff related to IP stuff, like what do you call it? Transformers and G.I. Joe and stuff like this, and people love those. And there's lots of trades coming out as well. It's true. Sage is saying, I kind of caught the tail end, but I love your streams. I watch a lot of them after they happen, just as VODs on Twitch. Cool. Awesome. Glad you like them, man. Or brother or sister. I talk to everyone as either man, guys, brother, sister. I use less, but correct me if I'm wrong. Okay. I'm glad you're enjoying them. I'm really enjoying sharing this information and sharing this content. It's keeping me on my toes, making me relevant, forcing me to learn all of this disruptive innovation that's being introduced. Brother, awesome. Thanks. Thanks, Sage. All of this disruptive innovation that's being introduced to us is fantastic to learn and use as a tool to share information and, in essence, build up my repertoire, build up the content, and create my company, create my business, what I plan on doing with mathematics, with the comic books, with whatever it might be, right? So it is a tool or a disposal to decentralize our lives, right? And allow us to have possibly multiple revenue streams just in case one gets cut off, we're not left hanging, right? Because that's one of the main things, main problems with our economic system. A lot of people have all their eggs in one basket, and that's sort of the ball and chain with people, right? They get into a company, work for 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, 5 years even. They start getting benefits and they start investing, buying RSPs and stocks of that company and stuff like this, and that's their ball and chain. Now they have a lot vested in that company, and if that company management changes, which it does, if it's public Wall Street, the first priority is to make money for the stockholder, right? Then the workers get burned. So to decentralize that, we have to use some of this disruptive innovation technology coming into play if we can, with the work that we do, which is me doing this stuff, which is fantastic, and it keeps me on my toes, keeps the brain sharp. Try to anyway, which is one of the main things you learn as you grow older. If you're not learning, you become stagnant, right? And you don't want to become stagnant. I've known too many people that are stagnant and way too comfortable in the space that they're in, and they're not ready for the world. And if anything goes wrong and they have a hard hit, that might take them out of the game. I've had a few hard hits, so I've learned to adapt, and this is part of my adaptation. So it's a pleasure to share, and thank you for being here. Thank you for being here, and thank you for watching this content. Keeps me coming back, keeps me coming back. So young blood, we got a minute left. If you have a math question, we do. It's been awesome to see your content and channel grow over the years. Yeah, thank you, man. It's seriously, when I started this, my main objective was to, and it is still, to teach math, to teach math to as many people as possible. And I really didn't initially plan on being in front of the camera. The reason I came in front of the camera was because I was trying to help a family member learn mathematics, me being in Canada and they being in the United States. So I started creating the math videos with Language of Mathematics, graffiti style, going out the tripod with chalk and editing and stuff like this. So cutting it with music or whatnot. So I learned how to edit, how to shoot video, how to record sound. Record sound came later. I wasn't incorporating mics and lapel mics and stuff. There's only so much I could learn in one shot. But it was amazing to do. And once I got the feedback from people saying thank you very much for this content and them finding use for it, that just gave me energy, motivation to create more and more. And here we are. I don't know how many years later, 12 years later, 13, 14 years later, 12? I don't know when my first video was out, 2006, I guess. So 12 years later of creating content, videos specifically, it's a pleasure to be here. What is 66 times 103? Let's end this with a math. 66 times 103. Let's do that. Let's change the angle. Chicho, any tips on sites you recommend for teaching little ones basic math? Oof, difficult. I would say the best thing you can use to teach kids mathematics is to play games, specifically board games. That is, to me, if I was at some point, hopefully I will do this, I will create a school, independent school, specifically for mathematics, right? But if I was going to teach kids mathematics, I would teach them board games and I would play board games. Okay. And two of the games I would play, one of them 100% would be backgammon and the other one would be chess. Okay. Those are the two games I would 100% introduce to kids. I would also do dominoes. Okay. I would also do Monopoly. Okay. Believe it or not, I would do Monopoly. And I will make another video of, we already made a video of how we play the variant version of Monopoly, and we've got another variant version we've introduced, and I'll show you that as well. And even that, doing the calculations in my head, in our head, and with our gaming group, sometimes we bring out the calculator trying to make sure we're doing it right. So it's adding, subtracting, multiplying, and stuff like this. I don't know any sites. I really don't. And I don't. I've tried out some sites and I've ended hating all of them. Right? There are some sites, some videos that I look up if I'm reviewing mathematics. But in general, I don't think I haven't come across any place that does a good job teaching preliminary and kicking it up the way I would do it. Okay. 103 times 66. Let's change the camera angle. Boop. 103 times 66. 103 times 66. 103 times 66, right? The first number multiplies these guys and you put them here. 6 times 3 is 18. And you put the 1 here. So anything more, 10 or more, you transfer over here the 10th digit, right? So 18. The one goes up here. 6 times 0 is 0, plus 1 is 1. So if there's any numbers here, you multiply this number by this number and then add the top. Okay. And then 6 times 1 is 6. And then when you move down, this is a 0 marker. So you bring down here, you put your 0, and then you multiply this with the rest of these numbers again. And 6 times 103 is the same thing as 6 times 103. So you can just copy this down again, right? 6 times 3 is 18. Again, you transfer to 1. 6 times 0 is 0, plus 1 is 1. 6 times 6 is 6, right? So it's just 618, 618. You just moved it over one, right? And then what you do when you have your layers done, you add these two or three, right? Instead of doing 6, well, let's do 6, let's not kick this up to 666, right? So this becomes 8. You add these, that's 9, that's 7, and the 6. So 106 times 66 is 6,798. Nice number. six, seven. I wish this was 6, 7, 8, 9, but it's not. 6, 7, 9, 8. Right? Fun. A multiplication. Well, that's about it. Youngblood didn't come back with a math question. But thank you very much. I gotta put my glasses on. It's easy. Aimba. Aim. I'm gonna call you Aim. You have a nice beard. Thank you. I like it. Hey, man. Our savior, Donald J. Trump. How's it going? Going good, brother. I hope you made that username after he was elected, not before he was elected. And if you did it before he was elected, kudos to you. You had faith. You had faith. Fun. So, guys, that's it. That's our last stream. Oh, Trump. Those are nice names, nice symbols. KJH0904. So that's about an hour. Thank you for being here for the streams, this day of math that we did, but it ended up being half a day of math and half comic books, I guess, right? I'm British. I hope you voted for Brexit. Thanks for the stream. My pleasure, man, my pleasure. Good night, good night. I'm Korean. Hello, Korea. Korea, I know a few words. Yeoppaseyo, bulgogi, japchae, kimchi. I love Korean food. I had a Korean roommate at university for like 3 years. I hung around Koreans a lot. I played a lot of poker with Koreans. Koreans love gambling. Bye bye, sir. Nice. Okay, gang. I'll see you guys in the next streams. And what I'm gonna do is these streams that we did, these six streams that we did in the last couple of days, I'm gonna load those up slowly on YouTube, starting most likely either Monday or Tuesday, most likely Tuesday. I'm gonna let the video I loaded on YouTube today just to float for a while. Okay, that's about it, gang. Hope you guys have a fantastic weekend. We'll talk later. Bye for now.